ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Youth Group. Tonight we will be starting the 40-day prayer challenge. If you've already started it, keep going and doing your thing. And next week we have Youth Group at church, so make sure to come out. We got food and games and all that good stuff. So yeah, OG Noah coming at you.
Does that have to be cringy? Okay.
Last week, I got to finish up our series by saying what love means to me now. And the bottom line was this: whether in relationships or in life, pray that you and I pray that we may discover what we really want. Hey, I did, and it means the world to me. I ended up with Monica, who is my favorite gift I've ever been given. And it's such a blessing to me that I can have that. Truly, once we know what we really want, we can dedicate our lives to refining it and pressing our efforts toward achieving it and receiving it. All in Jesus' name. And Tracy Vignovich, our junior and senior ladies leader, she has a great example of this in her own life. Her and Joe, our junior and senior boys leader, had decided very early on in their relationship they were not going to be a couple that broke up and then got back together and went back and forth like this. No, they had decided that if they were going to date, they're going to stay dating. If they're going to break up, they're going to stay broken up. And you see, this is a principle that has lasted throughout their lives. In fact, today, 27 years of marriage later, they can say that this is something that they have held to. That they had gotten together, they had prayed, they had decided what they wanted, and then they have spent a lifetime praying about it and going after it in order to achieve it and receive that from God. And it's such a blessing for us that we can look to their marriage and say, man, that is something that I am striving for. And even if it's not a relationship, maybe it's just something you desire, something you want. Pray for that and ask God to give that to you. And hey, somewhere along the way, what you want and what God wants, God will align those for you in your life. And you will have such joy at that alignment. So that's what we want to do. We want to pray to discover what we want. And then we want to work hard to achieve it and receive it. And surely along the way, we will all have a Jericho moment. Like those Israelites who had to trust God that walking around a wall would somehow knock down a building. Hey, there will be a time where what you want will seem out of grasp. And we will have to trust the Lord to get us through that, to get us past it, to help us in that situation. Jesus gives us confidence in this by saying it like this: in this life, there will be trouble. Hey, but take heart, for I've overcome the world. You see, it's not you having to overcome the world to get what you want. Jesus is saying, just trust in me. Take heart in me. Go hard after that in my name, and hey, we will make it happen, because he has already overcome the world. I love how Mark Batterson says it like this. He says, work as if it depends on you, but pray as if it depends on God. So these next 40 days, we're going to spend some time praying. Each and every day, 5 minutes a day, maybe more, we're going to say, God, I'm going to give my life up to you. I'm going to trust you. I'm going to ask you for what I really want in your name. And hey, after 40 days, we're going to be able to look back and say, man, I'm starting to understand how what I want and how God wants, how these are coming together. And I'm so excited for this journey with you guys. I'm so excited to make this happen. And it's going to be a grind, but we are going to do it and do it together. We're going to partner with our parents and say, hey, will you help remind me to do those 5 minutes of prayer? And at the end of it, we're going to give you a reward, 40 of something, because 40 days of prayer is a pretty exceptional thing. So guys, I'm excited, and let's get to it tonight. Have a great night.
Take